Okay, we have another important guest joining us, Rasesh Shah, Chairman and CEO of Edelweiss Financial Services. Rasesh, we are coming to your Edelweiss numbers in just a bit, but what are you going with for the market itself? If you look at the way the F&O positions are hedged, it's just, you know, writing calls at 6,100 and selling puts at 5,600 or thereabouts, so evenly hedged at this point in time. Where do you think the market might break, downward or upward?
I think overall, you know, the equity markets has held up fairly well in spite of the RBI tightening in the last few weeks and all. So there are quite a few optimists out there. But overall, I think this RBI tightening and everything else should put eventually pressure on, you know, quite a few companies, their ability to borrow, NPAs in banks and all of that. So eventually, I think there is increasingly a sense that the market should drift downwards. So I think there is enough cash, you know, coming in from LIC and others in the market so that it will not crash, but I think it will drift down slowly the way it has been, because overall it feels like the market has to factor in the impact of the recent RBI tightening and its impact on earnings and cash flow for the corporates.
Hi Rasesh, thanks for joining us. How are things looking on the brokerage end of the, you know, how are things looking for the brokerage side of the business, and what's your expectation how Edelweiss might perform for the full year?
I think on the capital markets activity and the brokerage side, it's been still fairly steady. Activity on the commodity and the currency side of broking has come down because of the restrictions on currency and commodity. Has also, you know, after the introduction of CTT, some amount of volumes have come down. So overall, I think the brokerage industry has been steady, and fortunately for us, now only about 7 to 8% of our total revenues come from broking. About more than 50-55 is on the credit side of the book, and then we have commodities and asset management and other incomes. So I think what we did over the last 5 years of diversifying our activity and ensuring that we were not overly dependent on any one stream has helped us. So we've been able to post about 40% growth in the first quarter on a YOY basis, and we hope that we'll continue to steadily continue to grow. Though I think the headwinds in the short term are still there, and largely because of the increase in cost of borrowing and the interest rates that have gone up.
Any increase in bad loans, Rasesh?
Since we mainly focus on collateralized loans, we haven't seen any impact at all. Our collateral cover is close to 2.5 times of the value of loan, and even in housing loan, our LTV is close to 56-57%. So we are not seeing the impact of that now. But I think slowly, if this tight monetary conditions stay, then I think all credit oriented firms should be very conscious and very cognizant of the fact that the borrower's ability to service, the borrower's ability to repay will get stretched, and people should, I think, start planning for that.
Fees and commissions have gone up by 17%. Is that sustainable?
I think our idea is to grow between 10 to 15%. The first quarter was good, but as I said, in this second quarter, a few headwinds have started emerging, slowdown in currency and commodities and all. But we're still hoping that between 10 to 15%, we're seeing activity in the capital markets, equity markets, to be at a steady level, because I think it's been almost 3 years of sideways. So to grow at about 10 to 15% should still be there. I hope so.
Actually, Rasesh, the markets have been in this range of 5,500, 600 to 6,100 for what, almost a year now. I can't remember when we had broken below this mark. And we've had a series of bad news thereafter. I mean, the rupee depreciation came in the past few months. The Fed tapering news has come thereafter. As well, the series of downgrades of GDP, from probably 5.7 to 5.5, and now more people veering towards 5 to 5.3%. The blow from the Reserve Bank, which should always have been read in the previous policy itself, that there is no further room for loosening at all. Maybe the tightening will be rolled back, but cuts are certainly not something which is the base case for anybody. Do you think the markets ought to adjust lower on that basis? Because liquidity should be at a risk, is already seen because of tapering, and fundamentals are also at risk.
True, I think it's an important question everybody is asking. I think our our understanding is that equity markets corrected a lot earlier and actually took a lot of the pain. And if you look at the index, you might get only one picture. But the if you look at the mid cap stocks and if you look at a broader market, the correction has been a lot sharper. But I think one of the other things that's also helping equity markets, and the markets have been reasonably robust given all the all the other things that are going around us, and our hypothesis on that is that there is a lot of asset reallocation going on, because a lot of investors were in commodities, because a year ago gold was doing very well, and we had always said at the start of the year that as gold prices have come down, there'll be some reallocation away from gold to equities. We are also seeing reallocation away from bonds to equities. People are moving away from from the mutual fund schemes in bonds into equities and all. So I think equities is relatively the worst possible the worst hit on this whole thing, and it's currently seen as a reasonably safe place to hold, because all the bad news is already there, while investors are worried about the bond markets as well as they are worried about the commodity markets.
So Rishesh, in the equity space, where does one park their money? Because the sectors which are doing well have already been are very, very expensive, whether it's FMCG or even IT is trading much at valuations much higher than where they used to be, and the other sectors and stocks are not doing so well. So where should one park money in equities?
I think currently we're still seeing a lot of interest in the IT sector, because though I think it has in the last 3-4 months it's been good for the IT sector, we're still seeing more and more over allocation to the IT sector, because with the rupee going down, with the US economy doing well, and the quarterly results have been reasonably okay. So on the whole, I think the one sector that is getting some more flows are IT. Pharmaceutical is doing well, and IT and pharma is not as heavily overvalued as maybe FMCG is. So investors are finding some comfort in there. We think the banks also look reasonably valued now, but I think still until the RBI monetary policy has been handled, I think investors will stay away from banks, but they are starting to become interestingly valued.
Okay, yeah, there are some brokerages that are coming with interesting buy ideas even on PNB after those numbers. Rashesh, thanks a lot. We have to thank you also because the finance minister has begun speaking. This is an important Dainik Bhaskar event.